Hello and good evening. This is Ruth Prosuello from Curbal.com, and today I'm going to show you how to import Twitter data from the API into Power BI. So let's go ahead. The first thing I want to show you is the person that actually came up with the code. This is his name, Chris. And I'm going to post a link to this blog post and just visit it. I mean, he has like great blog posts, and here you have a description on how to do what I'm going to show you. So if you prefer to read, you can just go to him and get the steps. So the first thing we need to do is to create a Twitter application. Is easier than you think. You just go and click on the link. You have to be logged in into Twitter if you want to access directly. Then what you need to do is to create a new app. You give a name for the app, Power Query, for example. Import data into Power Query. And they want to have the whole entire, this should be enough. So here we have it. And here you will have access to two things, the consumer key and the consumer secret. And you will need those for the authentication into Power BI. I think that is all that you need. You can change the permissions also, read only, read and write, or read, write and access direct messages. Just let's choose read only. Update settings. Okay, excellent. So now that we have created our application, let's go back to the site and see what it says. So we need to set this to read only. We've done that on the Twitter side. And then in Power Query in Excel, he's doing it in Excel, set privacy levels to ignore. So let's see, if we go to options, here in privacy, we have to say ignore the privacy levels. He explains on his blog post why we need to do that, and it's because a single query is combining multiple data sources, and that is not allowed in Power Query, which is a real pain actually. But you will have to ignore the privacy levels. We've done that. And now we copy the code. Here is the copy. Control C, and we go new source, blank query, advance, and paste. Now, there are two things we need to change. We need to change the consumer key, and we need to change the consumer secret to our Twitter account. And we've created that, so let's pick them up. So here we have the consumer key. Make sure that you keep the consumer secret as a secret. So consumer key, paste it there. Wait. And now let's get the consumer secret, which is that one. And here you have it. This is your Twitter data. Quite easy, right? So let's remove that. Don't need that one. We have this column we don't want. that. Okay. And here you have, a lot of information. Now, what this query is doing is actually using Twitter search API. Let's see what it is here. So it is searching for the name of his company, which is here. We are not that interested in that. What we want to do is do our own Twitter searches. So the best way to do that is to remove that and to create a query parameter so we can add our Twitter searches easily. So let's do that. We are going to change the name of this to Twitter search. I think I'm missing a T. So, and now we're going to create a parameter called search parameters, which is going to be a list, and we're going to search by power. Yeah, we can search Curbal, and we can search by Power Query, maybe. So, and default, we make Power BI concurrent. So now that we have the parameter, we just have to add it here. So search parameters There you have it. So let's see how this works. Let's see, we get text. And now we have Power BI tweet, because that's the one that we set as current. And we have user who tweeted that. We have to expand on that. Let's take a look at it. Entity. I mean, it's given us so much data. I usually clean that up. Name, and location. And now I want to remove all this stuff. Don't want to. Otherwise, we get analysis paralysis. Source. Don't care. And ID. Don't need. So, this is text. Everything is text. And let's go. Fix this, and we take the username, who said what. So now you can follow tweets from your, when somebody mentions your company or yourself. So this is quite handy. So now with these, you can start doing your own Twitter analysis. The code will give you access to the entire API, so you can just download followers and follow in and everything you need. I will continue doing more Twitter videos, but I think for today this is enough. You can play with it yourself. You will be able to download it from our site. I hope you enjoyed the video. As I said, we will have more Twitter analytics in the coming weeks. If you like it, please let me know. Any questions, you can contact me in any of the channels that we're available on. And subscribe, we publish around the video week. Okay, have a nice evening.